MLB The Show has baseball coming your way from Tropicana Field here in St. Petersburg. We've got an AL East contest tonight between the Boston Red Sox and the Tampa Bay Rays. Mookie Betts, with the season winding to a close, the AL's leading hitter makes his case for a batting crown. Next. Anthony Banda gets handed the ball for the fourth and final game of the series. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, it just goes to show you how tough it is to pitch in today's game. This guy has a career ERA over 5. At times he can be good, and at times he can be really, really bad. It'll be interesting to see which guy shows up in this one here today.
Leading off,
stepping
tonight for
in,
Boston,
Xander Bogaerts. He'll get us started Xander in this one under the Bogaerts lights. Curveball looked at here for strike one. Dan Dero, we take a look at the Rays entering play here tonight. 4-2 over their last 6 games, including a win last time out.
Yeah, Matty V, we're talking about a team that is white hot right now, Dero. They've won the first 3 games of this 4-game series. They'd like nothing more than Dero win this one here and finish it off to a nice 4-0 series.
Yeah, you take the first 3 in a series, you want to step on their throat right here. You don't get a chance too many times to take 4 games from somebody. They have that opportunity in front of them today.
Hit on the ground to third. And that's out number 1. And now here's how the visiting Red Sox line up in this one. Thoughts, Dan, who stands out?
Well, one thing's for sure, they love what Mookie Betts brings to their offense. I mean, this guy is a career 300 hitter. You talk about consistent. He delivers a good at-bat and clutch hits basically every time he walks into the box. I love watching this guy.
Here's the second baseman now, Dustin Pedroia, hitting 500 in the series so far, 4-for-8. First pitch of the at-bat. Ball one. And there are our umpires calling balls and strikes in this one, Mr. James Kingsley.
Dan, I know I was an offensive player, but...
Oh, and he misses it!
You know, D-Row, as a pitcher, that could be so frustrating. You're taught to try to go out there and make quality pitches, and that was a really good pitch. And I would be willing to bet you he's surprised that that turned into an infield single.
Yeah, at the end of the day, he's smiling. That hitter's smiling, running down first base, knowing he's got an infield single right there. He has no business. He'll line out probably 15 times, but it won't even out. You take him when you can get him.
Kiermaier is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Here's Mookie Betts. He's kept his average up in recent games. The competition has been fierce, but so far he's managed to fend off all comers in pursuit of a batting title.
Yeah, and if you're going to win a batting title, you wouldn't want it any other way. You don't want somebody to go in a massive slump and fall off the map. This is going to be a race to the end, two guys fighting it out, and who's going to have the best finish to the season.
And he's really continued to turn in strong performances day after day. His average in his last 10 games is over the 300 mark, and the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. Red Sox lead 1, Boston nothing. Tampa Bay coming up. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Chris Sale, a left-handed Floridian, will get the starting assignment. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, Matty V, we're getting a chance to watch a guy that's been struggling a little bit lately. In his last 3 starts, he has a whip of over 1.40, so he's going to have to cut that down. Limit the amount of base runners, limit the amount of walks if he wants to have some success in this one here today.
Stepping into the box, Matt Duffy. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. First pitch on its way. There's a fastball right down Broadway, taken for a strike. Guys, this Red Sox ball club entering play here tonight. They come off another loss last time out, and in fact, they've dropped 3 of their last 4.
Yeah, Matty V, and you know one thing you don't want to do here, D-Row? You've been on some good teams. Not to lose focus at this point of the year. Keep the big picture in sight, because there is a postseason lurking, and it's so easy to get ahead of yourselves and not take the rest of the schedule serious.
I think the nice thing for this team is that they won the division. They will, for whatever happens, get a 5-game series. It's not that 1-game wild card, win or go home. This team can prepare themselves to battle and try and win 3 out of 5.
And with that, a look at the Rays lineup card in this one. Mark, what's your take on him against one of the best starters in the game?
Yeah, Matty, you take a look at this lineup. The one thing that jumps out is the fact that they are last in stolen bases. They are station to station trying to hit the ball out of the ballpark, trying to get in good counts and drive the baseball out of the yard to create their runs.
The 1-0 home is taken, strike one.
I got a ball, one strike.
Now a ball lined to the left side, but this is a foul ball. Tried to hold up there, appeal down to first, and no swing. It's ball two. One out, nobody on. And he held up in time, but it's strike three called, and there were two down.
You know, I'm not quite sure how that strikeout will be scored, looking or swinging. He tried to check his swing, but I'm pretty sure the home plate umpire was ringing him up regardless.
Into the box, Tommy Pham. He's had a real nice season in the batting average department, but he'll need to turn it on a bit down the stretch if he wants a chance at claiming that coveted batting title. Sales ready. First pitch on the way. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0.
Here's a perfect situation. Two outs, bases empty, power hitter at the plate. He ain't looking for a single and hoping to pass the baton. This guy's looking to do damage.
Pham with an even 1-1 count now. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time. Bases are empty here with two men out. Three and one.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters' counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
Three and two now. Soft liner to the right side. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. And inning in the books tonight, still scoreless here on the show. Rafael Devers the next to bat. Just one for 10 in the series coming in, so he'll look for better results here today. First pitch on its way. First pitch is a changeup for a called strike. Devers, a native of the Dominican Republic. He's in his third season as a major league player. Strike two called on the inner half, 0-2 now.
Hey, I love the aggressive nature this guy's pitching with. He's got focus. He's commanding the fastball, really being aggressive right now. A lot different than his last start where he took a loss and seemed timid and scared to attack the zone. All right, let's take a look at the Tampa Bay Rays on defense. And, guys, today my spotlight's going to be on outfielder Austin Meadows. When I think of him, I think of one word, smooth. He's so sure-handed out there. Offensively, he's got that pretty swing, and defensively, he runs into the gap smooth, people. Lock in on this guy. He's going to be a star in the making.
Striding in, number 23. He's a guy hoping to finish strong in the season's final month. Definitely in the discussion for Rookie of the Year honors. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. No score here as we play inning number two. A high strike there, and it's 1-1.
There's a called strike on a changeup, not a particularly good one. That changeup up in the zone like this oftentimes gets hit very hard. Was able to get away with it that time, but if he's going to be successful, he's going to need to get that changeup down in the zone around the knees.
Now a swing and a miss. He struck him out, and it's two up, two down to start the second.
This is why it's so hard to be successful as a hitter when you fall behind in the count. One and two, you're probably expecting some sort of off-speed pitches, but when the pitcher offers up a good hard fastball, it's pretty hard to adjust and catch up to it.
Here's Jed Jerko now, as he'll lay off a curveball in the dirt for ball one. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. Ball Jerko in front, two balls and no strikes. Here's the 2-1 home. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three. Two out, nobody on. And this is taken for a ball. He walked him. And the Sox have themselves a two-out base runner.
Yeah, the guy's been on fire lately, hitting anything close. So I think this is the way to go here. Get the bat out of his hands any way that you can.
Digging in, Gorky's Hernandez. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Diaz is there for it, and that retires the side. One left for the Red Sox. We'll go to the bottom of the second, no score. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Jesus Aguilar comes into this one with three hits and 11 at-bats in the series.
Jesus Aguilar.
First pitch coming, here it is. Fastball in there for a called strike. Oh, got him to swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing in two.
Now on 0-2, I don't think we're going to see any more hittable fastballs. If we see one at all, it'll probably be extended out of the zone, or at least that'll be the intent.
The 1-2. Misses, ball two. Popped him up. Jerko over to his left. One out.
So here's how the both Sox are positioning themselves the right defensively. And guys, one thing I want you to focus on today when you look at this team on the defensive side of the ball, they're in the top five in fielding percentage. They go about their business a certain way. They make all the routine plays, mix in a few flashy ones, and day after day, they give their pitchers the best chance to be successful.
Stepping up now, Austin Meadows. He's hitting at a .500 clip in the series coming into this one. Five hits in 10 tries. He'll hold off on the slider to start the at-bat. It's ball one. Bottom of the second here with no score. Ripped down the first baseline. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And the effort pays off as he's able to recover and get the second out of the inning.
The first baseman.
And that'll bring in Yandy Diaz. Two hits and eight tries for the series. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And that's taken for strike one. Diaz is a corner infielder, normally a third baseman, but he's at the other corner at first base here in this one.
Yeah, this guy's got sure hands. You know, sometimes I want to make this point. First basemen get a bad rap because everyone thinks they could just go over there and handle a bag, pick balls in the dirt. Not the case. First basemen cannot be more important to helping out not only the pitching staff when they want to throw over, but also taking errors away from their infielders.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Ball. A ball and two strikes.
Okay, so now is where I think you pull the string. Throw the El Cambio up there. Hasn't seen it yet, and I think he's set up for it right here.
Swing and a miss got him reaching. Number 77 recovers, and the throw to first ends the inning. Down in order go the Rays. We'll move to the third with no score. At the plate, number 77, and he'll start out their half of the third, top of the order to follow.
Number 77.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Fastball well outside. Smoked on the ground up the middle, and a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
Dan, after that base hit right there, he's got a six-game hitting streak going.
You know what? And this could lead him on to something, some bigger and better things right here. He's been swinging the bat pretty well, and he's been rewarded for it, as you talked about. Six-game hitting streak so far.
Fly ball out to straightaway right. Meadows waits on it, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
The batter
one gone here in the Boston third, and that'll bring up the former MVP second baseman Pedroia. Dustin Pedroia. From the stretch, this is in the air out to straightaway center. Kiermaier is there, two gone. Striding out for Boston, J.D. Martinez, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. First pitch on its way. In there, no balls and a strike.
Jumped ahead with strike one there, and that's something he's going to do a lot of in this start. He doesn't have lights out stuff, so it's important for him to be pitching ahead and have the hitters on their heels.
A step on second for the force, and that'll do it. One hit, one left. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three, and we are tied 0-0. Up next for the Rays, number 67, 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
Not much going on offensively so far for these guys. Six up, six down. We'll see if the bottom part of the lineup can get something going.
Well, the home crowd seems a little restless, so I'm sure they'd appreciate it. In there at the knees as he offers a strike to the leadoff man, 0-1.
He looks really strong here early in this game, and that fastball is a good example. Put that thing in a great spot and right where he wanted it.
Count now a ball and a strike. A ball and two strikes to the Rays shortstop.
The MO of this pitcher in the early going is certainly establishing the inside part of the plate. He has been dominant. Sometimes you just got to tip your hat if a guy can effectively, consistently pitch inside like he is.
They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
My man on the mound has just got great strikeout stuff working for him these days. Looking back at his last start, he racked up 9 Ks, and now he's looking like he can put up similar numbers in this one.
Now at the plate, Nick Schuffo. Here's the pitch. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. Bottom of inning number three, 0-0 our score. Just missing here, 2-0.
Yeah, that looked like a strike, but let me tell you, when you're staring at a big zero in the hit column, getting a call like that to go your way can feel like a big victory.
And here's a fastball for a strike, 2-1 now. There's a shin-high slider laid off for a ball.
3-ball count right now. This looks like the best chance of getting a base runner run so far.
Bases are empty, one man out.
Aye.
3-2.
Count is 3-2.
Ball four.
Ball four.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Kevin Kiermaier.
Stepping in, Kevin Kiermaier, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. He's set, and the pitch. Here's a strike with the breaking ball.
This is a tough guy right here to hit into a double play. He's fast and he swings from the left side, so out of the box he's going to get a good break. You might have to try to get the strikeout right here, because very rarely are you going to get this guy to ground into a double play.
This is on the ground over the first. The second for one, and good hustle by the pitcher there on the back end as it's a 3-6-1 double play, and the side is retired. Pretty painless half of the inning all told. Three innings complete, and we are tied 0-0. also striding in.
Mookie Betts,
who's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
Strike two on a fastball right down the middle.
Can't say he's tickling around the zone. Those last two pitches were pretty much grooved right down the middle, but it didn't bite him.
Popped him up. Robertson over to his right. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
Now back. I'm sure his eyes lit up when he saw that curveball hanging in the zone. But maybe he tried to do too much with it because basically he hit it straight up. No doubt he wants that pitch back. And the pitcher, he just dodged a bullet.
Standing in now, Rafael Devers. As he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. High and deep down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. Big breaker that time as it catches the inside for a called strike.
Hey, I watched Tom Glavine master throwing changeups inside to right-handed batters and getting them to pull it foul. If this guy can command that front hip curveball, he's going to go to it all game.
Duffy is over and he tucks it away for the second out.
Now batting.
Standing in, number 23. He's 0 for 1 thus far. First pitch on its way. And there's a line drive. Base hit to left field.
Dan, that can't bother you too much as a pitcher. Guy swinging first pitch.
Now, one of the things you want to do, D-Row, is you have to try to get ahead with the first pitch. You want to throw one of the first two pitches for strikes. Unfortunately, sometimes when you bring the ball in the strike zone, you're bound to give up some base hits, but hopefully he can minimize the damage here.
And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. All over that one, but a little out in front. Foul ball. Now a ball lined to the left side. But this will be a foul ball. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
On 0-2, you'll sometimes get a guy to chase a fastball out of the zone away or up. But when it's way down like that, it's much easier to lay off because you can tell the ball is moving further away from eye level as it comes in.
Two balls and two strikes now. Line to the right side. Meadows is there and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Red Sox leave one. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Ready for another chance? Matt Duffy. And he'll step in to start things out against Chris Sale. Here's the first pitch to him. And that fastball's taken but catches the outer third. Duffy, often known as the Duff Man in baseball circles, he's a five-year vet at the major league level. Here's the 0-1 pitch. And it's 1-1.
1-1.
And a half-hearted attempt that time as he broke the plane of the plate. It's a ball and two strikes now. The 1-2 is a fastball that misses. And a slider. Oh, got a favorable call on that one as that's the first out of the inning.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Now a changeup, but it misses just a little below the zone. First time up, he went down looking. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1.
That pitch up in the zone called the strike, and that's a tough pitch for a batter to hit, though, that fastball that's high in the zone.
And this is taken for a called strike, and he's not in love with that call either. It's 1-2 now. A bouncer to the left side, fielded cleanly. Throw gets him, two down.
Now batting.
The left ready field. Now, Tommy Pham. This guy is still looking at a zero in the hit column. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Now a slider, and he gets ahead of him here, 0-1. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Sales ready. 2-1 on its way. Now a half swing here on the pitch inside, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the home plate umpire. Strike two. Hit hard down the right field line, but a foul ball. Started to chase that time, but then he wisely holds off for ball three. And that one's taken outside for a ball. We walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Pulled the fastball down a little too much there. That's ball one. The short hit hard. Gloved by Bogarts. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. One left for Tampa. Through four. Still tied. Nothing, nothing. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Well, Matt, I talked with manager Alex Cora during the break about his thoughts on the Red Sox hitters to this point. And flat out, he told me they just need to put better swings on the ball right now. He said they're searching for ways to drive the ball with some authority because it's just not happening for them today. They haven't gotten an extra base hit yet, so it's been a real struggle getting guys into scoring position. But the key, he said, is not to panic. Sometimes you just have to fight through the downturns and keep your focus and energy high.
Thank you, Heidi.
Gorky Hernandez.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. That's inside. 2-0. Now the 2-0 home. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field.
Hey, guys, I like the execution by the batter there. He got a hanger in the middle of the plate. He could have come unglued, but he didn't. He stayed focused and drove a line drive base hit.
Into the box now, number 77, as he takes a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. Here's a fastball at the knees. Good spot, good pitch, and it's 0-2.
Man, you find yourself down 0-2 after two great executed pitches right there. Got to look for something up. Might have to tip your hat if he can stay down below the knees like that.
Another 0-2 home. Tried to get him out front, but it's a ball 1-2. Back up the middle. And that's through for another base hit. He'll make it 2-for-2 in this one.
Hey, two runners on after back-to-back singles right there. They are in prime position to put the first run on the board right here.
Here's Xander Bogaerts now as he'll take a look at ball one. Looking at his lifetime numbers, Bogaerts carries a hitting line just over the 280 plateau.
D-Rod.
1-1. No runs, 5 hits, and no errors for the Red Sox to this point. 2-1 now to the Boston leadoff hitter.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be aggressive. You can pretty much count on a pitcher. He's trying to get back in the strike zone. And with two guys on base right here, it's time to grip it and rip it.
Pham comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. Next up for the Red Sox, Dustin Pedroia. It was a flyout for him in his last.
Pedroia.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Pham is back to the warning track, and he's able to put it away for the second out. Here's J.D. Martinez, and we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And he gets ahead with the curveball, strike one. Down the third baseline, and this gets right through him, and that may be a run. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0.
Boy, it's been tough to score in this one so far through the fifth inning, but that RBI base hit right there is a nice breakthrough.
Yeah, it's been a great pitcher's duel up until this point. They've been executing on the bump without question, but that RBI knock right there might set the tone for the later inning.
Stepping in now, Mookie Betts, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. So far this season, with runners in scoring position, Betts has an eye-grabbing batting line, one that resides above the 340 plateau.
Maddie, he's having one of those dream seasons right now. The ability to work the count, the ability to get on base north of 400, and having a great bat.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. So it's a run on 3 hits, no errors, and 2 men left on. Last half of the fifth coming up. Boston's out in front, 1-0. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, Rays manager Kevin Cash talked to me in between innings about his lineup's offensive production. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out of their at-bats right now. He said that they're playing right into the pitcher's game plan today by expanding the strike zone way too often. Instead of swinging at pitches in the strike zone that they can do something with, they're often chasing at pitches out of the zone, which is resulting in a lot of their outs. Going forward, they have to start being more selective,
leading
guys.
Off for the Rays.
All right, Heidi, thank you.
The right fielder, Austin Meadows.
First offering on its way. Nope. Close there, but he doesn't get the call with the breaking ball. And he watches one miss outside, 2-0 now. Sale ready with the 2-0. 3-0 now.
If you're ever going to see a position player go to the mound, it's going to be in a situation like this. Get him to relax a little bit, focus on his mechanics, and get that fastball back in the zone. Can't allow this guy to lead off walk.
Taking all the way that time, it's 3-1. Grounded to first. Jerko fields it cleanly, and he'll step on first for the out, 3 unassisted. Well, it's still early, but it's also worth noting that he'd be in line for the win if this keeps up as we take a look at the league leaders in games won this season. And as you see, he's right up there among league leaders in that department. Digging in for his second at-bat, Yandy Diaz looking. First pitch coming, here it is. Well, fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0.
These guys have got to be frustrated as an offensive unit so far in this one. They haven't been able to crack the code on their opponent, but it's not like they're getting great pitch stand either. This starter has kept the ball on the corners of the zone all game long.
In time to first, and there are 2 away.
Now batting.
A look at our line score
number
to this
67.
Point, and I'm almost certainly jinxing things by pointing it out, but it's worth mentioning that zero in the hit column through two outs here in the fifth. Now at the plate, number 67. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, Matty, big time K last time up, and it's been a tough series for him so far. You can tell he's just not seeing the ball off this team. Let's see if he can make an adjustment right here.
Ball one to start the at-bat. Sale into the windup. 1-0 on its way. Hit down the third baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Three and one.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
The 3-1 pitch. Takes a strike for a full count now, 3-2. Swinging a soft liner, and this will be taken down no problem for the final out of the inning. Rays go in order, 1-2-3. It remains 1-0. Roberto Chavez is into the ballgame now as he'll make his fifth appearance of the season here.
Roberto Chavez.
Standing in, Rafael Devers. No hits to this point.
The designated hitter, Rafael Devers.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And that misses ball one.
I don't know why in the world anybody would want to be an umpire. That manager has given this umpire an earful on a pitch that he thought was a strike, and he's certainly trying to defend his pitcher.
Pham is over toward the line a bit as he takes it for the first out.
Now
digging in once again, number 23. A hit in two tries so far. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Checks his swing, but this pitch is right there for strike one. One run, six hits, and no errors for the Red Sox to this point. This one's blooped out toward right center field. Robertson ranging into shallow right. He can't get to it. This one's down.
Man, he's seeing it like a beach ball right now. Even his soft contact is finding holes, Dan.
He's making it nearly impossible for a pitcher right now. Up, down, in and out, hard, soft. Anything you throw forward to home plate, this guy seems to somehow be able to find a hole.
Meadows is after it. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. Ready once again, Gorky's Hernandez. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. First delivery to him on the way. Into right field, that's a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Now batting, number 77.
Digging in and looking for more, number 77. We'll see if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. Hit on the ground toward the left. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Boston strands a couple. They lead it 1-0. Digging in to try it again, Nick Schuffo. He'll lead things off for Tampa here in the sixth.
We're moving through the middle of this ball game right now. If they want to get things going, how about trying to get some base runners on or at least get a base hit? They don't have any hits going into this part of the game.
Now here it comes. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. Schuffo, a native of South Carolina. He's in his rookie year here at the big league level. A 1-2 count to the Rays catcher.
Awfully frustrating for a pitcher. You make a close pitch like that, that just barely misses. Whew, that's a tough one to get back.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
Wow, that's awfully impressive right there. The pitch before was really close. Called the ball. What does he do? He comes back with a better pitch and gets the punch out.
Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. A ball and no strikes.
Ball one, no strikes.
Fastball misses away here. It's 2-0. One out, nobody on. And he squares up on this one. Deep to straightaway right. Back goes Betts. Still ranging back. Gone! Solo shot to right center. 19th home run for him on the season. And with it, the Rays have drawn even at one apiece.
Well, you really can't blame the man on the mound. He single-handedly kept them in this thing. But with one swing of the bat, we're all knotted up. Things are officially interesting, and we're in for a good finish in this one.
The batter, into the box, the Matt baseman. Duffy. Matt. As he'll take Duffy. A look at a high strike that time, it's nothing in one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
Case in point right there, Matty. We're seeing a trend, the north and south. A lot of pitchers working that elevated fastball and then breaking stuff off in the dirt. We used to see east-west, not the case anymore.
So he punches him out looking at the fastball. Matt Duffy becomes out number two this inning.
We know he's probably still thinking about that game-tying home run he just gave up, but I'm going to give him credit for not showing that it's bothering him. When you come back and strike out the next guy, it shows you've still got your head in the right place.
That gets down, and the inning will continue. The throw into second. And the gamble will work out. He's in at second base with a two-out double.
Now batter.
There's no question he's been struggling at the dish. Right? He's trying to do anything to get himself going. So he's got to feel pretty good after that double. Not to take anything away from him, but I think I could have probably hit that pitch.
Yeah, that's one of those gift pitches, not the location he was shooting. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes.
Right here, he's looking to get himself into a good hitter's count so he can take a rip and maybe give his team the lead. He certainly has the power.
Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike. Struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. But the Rays are able to knot things up on the solo home run. Top of the order due up to start the seventh, all even at one apiece. Back here at Tropicana Field in St. Pete, all square at one as we get set to start the seventh. But before we do, let's take a look at the game summary to this point. Austin Pruitt is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.
Number 45, Austin.
So the Red Sox lineup turns over, and to the plate, Xander Bogaerts. Already the beginning of the seventh inning here, as this game has had a very brisk pace to it so far. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. A ball and a strike. The 1-1 is looked at for ball number two. Slider misses, and he's in danger of losing him here, 3-1.
Walks are never good, but they're especially bad news late in games like this. It seems like they always come back to bite you.
The 3-2 pitch. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. The 3-2 one more time. Line towards center field. And he will run this one down, moving to his right, and that's the first out of the inning.
I know they say sometimes that these things even out, but that was a bullet line drive that gets caught. He would have represented the go-ahead run.
In now, Dustin Pedroia. And he'll quickly send a line drive to center field. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
Now batting, left fielder, J.D. Martinez.
Coming to the plate now, J.D. Martinez. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Changed up on him and dropped it in for a called strike.
You know, guys, sometimes guys don't like pulling the trigger 0-0. They want to see something go by, calibrate the speed, calibrate the break, and then make their adjustments off that. Maybe that's the case right here.
Hard hit towards center. And this is going to get down for what should be extra bases. And there's your potential go-ahead run. And your go-ahead run is in there at second base as he's got himself a two-out double.
Wow, the pitcher must be just shaking his head. That pitch wasn't anywhere near the strike zone, but he gave it the old tomahawk chop and somehow connected with it anyway. Now he's standing on second, and he even has to smile about that one.
Stepping into the box, Mookie Betts. Bit of an uncharacteristic performance from the league's batting average leader as he's been held hitless so far today.
You know, you amass so many ABs, usually an O for this late.
And the right fielder is there to make the catch, and the inning is over. Danger averted following the two-out double. Back with more Monday Night Baseball following this. Digging in, Jesus Aguilar. He's batting cleanup in this one, but we'll get us started here in the inning as they look to wake up the bats.
Yeah, not much to get excited about with just the single notch on the scoreboard, but you have to give credit to where it's deserved. The pitching on the other side has been really impressive.
Below the knees, one ball, no strikes. On the ground to the right side. And that will get through into right, so there's your possible go-ahead run on base to lead off the inning.
You know, D-Row, the old school thinking sometimes is when you're going through a bad streak like this guy, any way you can get on a little jam shot, even though it wasn't pretty, maybe this could get this guy finally going.
Yeah, I can't tell you how good that had to feel right there. There's moments where you slap that donut off your bat, you don't even want to walk to home plate. You're scuffling so bad.
Austin Meadows stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. Go-ahead runs aboard here at first with nobody out. Now a changeup, but it misses just a little below the zone.
On 2-0, you can bet he's looking for a fastball that he can turn on and drive. Might be thinking about picking on that big hole between first and second.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. Martinez has a read on it, and that's the first out of the inning. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Yandy Diaz. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one. First pitch of the at-bat. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Yeah, it really does, Matt, but this offense isn't helping him too much. It sort of feels like the next team to score is going to win this thing.
One ball, one strike, the count. The set and the 1-1 pitch. hit out towards second. There is Pedroia to second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. We're back with more on this Monday night after this. So digging in now, Rafael Devers. In his career against this pitcher, he's a .333 hitter. He also has one home run. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Hit hard up the middle. And this is going to be through into center field for a base hit as the leadoff man's aboard in the eighth.
Hey, Dan, obviously good game plan by the offensive team. Bunch of knocks, but they can't seem to get any runs going.
Boy, I tell you, as a pitcher, Dero, you're always trying to minimize the damage.
Into the box now, number 23, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. So far, 2-for-3 in this one.
I always say hitting's a process of elimination at the plate. I think he could go ahead and eliminate changeup. Two in a row, back-to-back, I don't think there'll be a third.
On a line to shortstop, but the runner is back to avoid the double play.
Now batter, the first baseman.
Andrew Benintendi will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
He's hitting for Boston. Number 16, Andrew Benintendi.
In there at the knees, strike one. And this one's downstairs. It's a ball and a strike. Now here's a line drive, and this is going to get down for extra bases. And this one bounds around against the wall. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double.
This guy just feasts on mistakes up in the zone, and that's exactly what he gets right here. A belt-high pitch, he drives into the alley. Great chance now with two runners in scoring position.
So coming to the plate, Gorky's Hernandez. He singled his last time up. First pitch of the at-bat. Into right field, that's a base hit. And the go-ahead run will score from third as they've taken the lead here in the late going.
Dan, you'll take RBIs any way you can get them, but when they give your team the lead in the late innings, man, that feels good.
Oh, it especially does, especially when you start to score runs late in the game off of quality pitching. When runs are at a premium, that's one makes you feel really good about yourself.
There's a good breaking ball as it gets the bottom of the zone. Runners are at the corners with one man out. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike.
With two strikes and the runners at the corners, this is a big pitch coming up. Got to execute to hope to either get a strikeout or a double play ball to help you get out of this thing.
Throw in time at first for out number two. But one's all they get as the run scores.
Xander Bogaerts.
Now to the plate, Xander Bogaerts. Runner in scoring position with two gone. Line to the right side, but he will close fast out there in right field as he comes on to put it away, and the inning is over. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left. Mitch Moreland is going to come on as a defensive replacement now as he takes over at first base.
Number 18, Mitch
Moreland. Ready for another shot now, number 67.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
Starts him out with a slider for a strike. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Into the corner and slicing foul. Lays off that time, and it's one and two.
I know you have to protect the strike zone when you get the count to two strikes, but on an 0-2 pitch that misses by that much, it's pretty easy for a hitter not to swing at that one.
Count even at two and two. The 2-2. He's at the knees and called strike three. So you've got to figure he's got a good chance here to finish this one off. And with that in mind, we take 19. A look at the league leaders in complete games. And as you see, he's right up there among league leaders in that department. And that'll bring up Nick Schufo. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. First pitch on its way. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Next pitch here will be number 100 through 7 1/3.
Man, I'd love to see a complete game. He's certainly on his way. If he can keep the number down, the pitch count down, he's got a shot at this.
Yeah, Dero, this is every manager's dream spot right now. You're one out into the eighth inning. Your starter's giving you some good baseball, and you could go to your better relievers now towards the end of the ballgame. This is set up perfectly right now.
The 1-2. Checked his swing there, and did he go? No, he did not, says the third base umpire. Ball two. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Kevin Kiermaier is on deck. Hit back up the middle. A dive, and he knocks it down. Throw will not be in time at first. A good effort that time, but not enough to prevent him from getting a one-out base run.
The better fielder, Kevin.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Here's a slider to start things out, but it misses by a few inches or so. It's ball one. Schufo stands at first with one out. And it's a ball and two strikes to Kiermaier now.
I'll tell you, we're in the later stages of this ball game, but his fastball is still coming out of his hand with plenty on it.
Out in front as this is pulled foul into the seats.
That wasn't a terrible pitch right there, but if he's going to execute and get this swing and a miss, he's going to have to get that ball a little bit further down, maybe even potentially bounce the next one.
Easy take there as the off-speed pitch misses well inside. A full count to the Rays center fielder.
One of the things you want to do with a starter, get that pitch count up. Here's another productive at bat as this count now gets to 3 balls and 2 strikes.
Now the 3-2 pitch gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout.
The third baseman, number 5.
So the lineup flips over and digging in, Matt Duffy, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. He's set. Here it comes. Now a check swing on the pitch inside, but he definitely broke the plane, and that's the first strike. Two out with the man at first. Behind 0-2 now.
I know it's a guessing game, but usually when you flip that coin, it better come up fastball at this level. You cannot be late right there. That was right in the wheelhouse.
And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ballgame, and the inning is over. Rays strand just the one, and it remains a 3-1 ballgame. Now batting, Dustin Pedroia. He'll start things off in the top of the ninth as they...
Dustin Pedroia.
Jeremy Jeffress enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. behind 0-2 now. Swing and a liner. Foul. Right down Main Street, caught him looking.
That's a pretty unique pitch sequence, guys. Usually pitching is all about mixing pitches and location, but he threw that all out the window to get that strikeout. He offered the same pitch three times in a row, so I guess he sort of used that reverse psychology to outthink his opponent.
Right-hander against right-hander, as this is a ball 1-0. Two hits in four attempts to this point. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Bases are empty, one man out. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. A swing and a shot hit down the corner, and foul, though it had the home run distance. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Grounded back up the middle. And that'll get through into center field for a base hit. So he waited till the ninth inning, but he comes through here to extend the hit streak. That was close.
Yeah, Matty B, you see that wry smile of him coming out of the box right there? He knew what was on the line. He'd be lying if he didn't.
Well, there's a lot of pressure on you because you're walking into that batter's box thinking,
And hold on there. That's not going to get him in there with the stolen base. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. Grounder down the line at third, but this will wind up foul, still 0-2. Lifted the other way out to left center. Pham giving chase. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. One left for the Red Sox, and it's still 3-1. Ladies Matt Barnes comes out of the bullpen to shut things down now here in the ninth.
Number 32, Matt Barnes.
Trying to pick things up where we left off. Daniel Robinson and he and his fellow top of the order hitters haven't really offered much help for this lineup so far.
No, your 1-2-3 guys are the ones you look to generate a lot of action, and they just haven't been up to the task so far in this one. Still time for them to turn it around, though. We'll see if it happens.
Strike one to start the at-bat. The pitch. And that changeup makes him jump, a swing and a miss. Lifted in the air to shallow center field. Hernandez moving forward. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. And there are the final numbers for the Boston starter. And he was really in command on the mound throughout the evening.
Superb pitching performance in this one, Matty V. 8 rock-solid innings in line for the win. Now needs some help from the bullpen.
Into the box now, Tommy Pham. Career numbers against Matt Barnes. He's 0-4. First delivery to him on the way. A changeup floats outside here for ball one.
This is the big out to get right here. This is their best hitter. He's a great hitter, and he's a guy that kind of spark plug. He gets this team going. So if I'm on the mound right now, you really want to try to get this guy out to hopefully keep them from getting a potential big inning started.
And this will find the wall out near the visitor's bullpen. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
That's what you call a clutch piece of hitting. Down two runs, he puts himself in scoring position and brings the tying run to the plate. We'll see what they do with the base open here. This one's getting interesting.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Jesus Aguilar. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. From the belt, kicks and deals. And he misses inside with that one, ball one. The 1-0. Gets him to chase a ball out of the zone for the first strike.
This is the stuff that infuriates a manager. You have to think the game. You got to know he's trying to pitch around you. You cannot swing at that pitch out of the zone.
A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back.
Classic change of speeds right there. Threw the hitter's timing off. Got a late foul ball. Interested to see where he goes now.
And it's two balls and two strikes now.
He's got him on the ropes at 2-2, but I don't think he'll try to get him out with another curveball. He's seen it already a couple of times, so it's not going to surprise him anymore.
The 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now. Austin Meadows waits on deck. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Hit the other way out toward right field. Betts has a read on it. He makes the catch, and the runner from second will tag and head for third. And he'll go ahead and take third on the fly ball to right, so he's 90 feet away now with two men gone.
Tampa Bay.
Into the box now, Austin Meadows. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. From the stretch. Oh, here's the shot out to right center. Now this will rattle up against the wall. And the run will score from third to make this a 3-2 ball game.
Just some more of the same from him. He's been clutch all year with runners in scoring position. And he does it again here with another. Tack on another RBI to his season total.
At the plate, Yandy Diaz. Been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
No doubt, some saves come easier than others, and I know this all too well. They're really making wrapping this thing up a difficult task.
High and deep to left center field, Hernandez racing back to the track, and this will bang up against the wall. And the run will score from second as we are once again tied 3-3.
How about it? Number 67.
And now time will be called here as you see the pitching coach making his way out to the mound to pay a quick visit. Now in the box, number 67. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game up to this point, but none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the...
Here's the first pitch. Didn't quite catch the zone there, ball one.
Got to believe the manager didn't have this in mind when he went to the bullpen. This reliever's got to step up right here. It's starting to tickle a little bit after getting hit around early.
Ready with the 1-0. Swing and a miss out in front of a changeup. And some action now in the Boston bullpen as a right-hander's up and throwing. The 1-1 pitch. And did he go around? No, he did not. Ball two. Possible winning runs at second with two down, however. Hard hit ball to second. Off balance throw gets him. Nice play there as the side is retired. But disaster has already struck here in the bottom of inning number nine as two runs come across and they'll have to work a little longer to try and pull... Digging in, number 23 on the night.
Leading
he's 2-for-4 with a pair of singles.
The third baseman.
First pitch number on its way. Hard hit ball to second. Throw to first gets him. One out here to lead off the 10th. Eduardo Nunez will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning.
Eduardo Nunez.
No balls and one strike. That batting average hovering in the high 230s. Four home runs and 22 RBIs. Comes set with the 0-1. Now a splitter's in there, and he's quickly behind, nothing in two. Nunez is unlike many of today's hitters in the sense that he doesn't have a lot of swing and miss in his approach at the plate. More often than not, he gets contact, and I'm sure that makes him a frustrating hitter to face from a pitcher's standpoint.
You know, he takes his chances when he has count leverage. Without question, 1-0, 2-0, you see this guy trying.
First delivery to him on the way. Whoa, knuckle curve down below the knees, 1-0. Two out, nobody on. And that's right there, and we're even at one. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And this is going to get down for what should be extra bases. And there's your potential go-ahead run. And he'll pull into second with his fourth hit of the ball game.
Now batting, number 77.
Riding in once again, number 77. It's been a 2-for-4 effort for him so far in the ballgame. Here's the first pitch. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Comes set, the 0-1. And there's strike two as the fastball's fouled off to the right. Nothing in two. Popped up. Diaz has room in foul territory. And the inning is over. Red Sox leave one. No change in the score. It's 3-3. Keith Hembree comes on to start the home 10th, and he's just hoping to get this one into the 11th inning.
Keith Hembree.
Brock Holt is going to come on as a defensive replacement now as he takes over at first base.
Number 12, Brock Holt.
Digging in now, Nick Schuffo. 1-for-2 in the ballgame thus far.
For the Rays, the catcher, number 19.
First pitch of the at-bat. And he starts him out with a strike on the outer half. Behind 0-2 now. Swing and a miss there as the breaking ball takes care of him for the first out.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one.
Now
the bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And a curveball drops in there for strike one. Right-hander starts to loosen out from the bullpen now. And that misses 1-1.
We got one ball, one strike.
This is on the ground over to first. Oh, what a stop on the slide. In time. So Tampa's batting order turns over and set to go. Matt Duffy, he struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Got to find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
Here's the 1-0. Grounded to short. Bogarts has it. Throw on to first, and we are going to the 11th inning. Down in order go the Rays. Still tied 3-3. Ladies Dominic Leone takes the mound to start the 11th inning.
Now pitching for the Rays, number 55, Dominic Leone.
Now at the plate, Xander Bogaerts. His prior history in this matchup, he's hitless in six tries.
The shortstop
hit hard on the ground to first. Diaz has it, and he'll step on first himself for the out.
Now back.
Stepping up to the plate, Dustin Pedroia. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Watches a fastball right there for strike one. One out, nobody on. And a swing and a miss that time by Pedroia as he finds himself in an 0-2 hole now.
Hey, guys, that's just a nasty pitch right there. I can't tell you how many nightmares I've had about nasty sliders, and that's exactly what that was right there.
The count now at 2-2. The 2-2. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good.
Well, he might be feeling a little bit of a sting there, but he could take comfort in knowing that he represents the go-ahead run. That could turn out to be a huge hit by pitch.
In now, J.D. Martinez. There's one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. The 0-1 is a fastball low, and that evens the count at 1-1. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Hit hard towards center, and that's in there. Base hit. And with that, the go-ahead runs up to second now with only one away.
Boy, this guy is off now to some kind of series, and he's one of the better road hitters in all of baseball.
Dan, some guys just have a knack for lighting it up on the road, getting that good night's sleep, and finding a way to get to the yard early and work on their craft.
Standing in now, Mookie Betts. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And nearly a three-run shot. Instead, it's a foul ball. Oh, can't spot the cutter any better than that. Nothing in two now. Good job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2.
That's a great take right there. You knew the pitcher was going to try and expand the zone, 0-2 in a big spot, and he was able to spit on that one, hopefully get something in the heart of the plate this pitch.
Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Meadows is in pursuit, but this will land untouched. A bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
This is exactly the reason why this guy has been so successful and has played this game so long, scrambling pitch after pitch, making this guy work out on the mound.
Oh, this is kind of unforgivable for the second baseman. He tries to square himself to the throw the second to start the double play, and I'm not sure what happened next. Maybe his cleats got stuck, or maybe he just lost the grip, but the net result is E4 with two men on board.
Into the box, Rafael Devers. Reined in. Robertson for one. On to first, but not in time as he beats it out.
Looked like that might be an inning-ending double play off the bat. But that was some great hustle to beat the throw at first. Keeps the inning alive, and more importantly, he gets an RBI because of it.
In now, number 23, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. He's looking for his third hit of the ball game here. And he misses with it, 1-1.
You know he wants that on the mound, especially if it would have made the count 0-2. Didn't get it, though, so now you have to make another quality pitch on 1-1.
Again, another foul ball. Runners at the corners, two men out. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And the throw to first is in time, but the damage has been done as the side is retired. Red Sox settle for just the one. One last shot here as we go to the bottom of the 11th now. The Red Sox 4. Tony Renda will stay in the ballgame now and take over in left field.
Now playing left field, number 43.
Ryan Brazier takes the mound in a safe situation as he'll try and make sure this one doesn't reach the 12th. At the plate, Daniel Robertson.
Leading off for the Rays, the second baseman, Gaggio.
First delivery to him on the way. Here's a slider to start things out, looked at for ball one. Brazier has thrown a little over 50 innings, and in that time he's posted an earned run average under one. Hit to third. He's got it. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Coming to the plate now,
Tommy Pham.
He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here. Third baseman hugging the line here. Now the first pitch. And that's off his leg on the mound. Thankfully, he's able to recover, and he gets the second out at first. And with that play over now, time to check and see if our man is all right. You can really see him favoring that leg. And that is his plant leg, which is always a concern. But from the way he's acting out there, I think it looks like he's going to be okay to try and continue. To the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Jesus Aguilar. He flew out in his last at-bat.
Almost, Matty. Almost went. This guy's big power. He's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB. I can't speak from experience, but that's got to feel good right there, throwing it.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. On the run, and he makes the catch just shy of the wall. And with that, this ball game is over.
Well, they had to put in a couple of extra innings of work, but hey, listen, a win is a win, and any win is good, especially on the road.
And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ball game. The Red Sox with their 103rd win to set the pace in the division. Heath Hembree claims the win out of the pen, his first. Ryan Brazier earns the save out of the bullpen, his sixth. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.